A new study indicates cancer is more likely to be caused by a patient's lifestyle as opposed to bad DNA. So Stony Brook University researchers say 9 out of 10 cancers are caused by factors such as smoking, drinking, sun exposure, and air pollution. USA Radio Network's chief political correspondent, Scotty Nell Hughes, with us from D.C., Fox News Medical A-Teams, Dr. Mark Siegel, right here with me in New York. So first and foremost, Doc, is this true, 9 out of 10 cancers? Does that sound right to you?
Well, it's somewhere between 7 out of 10 and 9 out of 10, but I actually agree with this, and it's a reversal, Deirdre, of a previous study done at the beginning of the year at Hopkins, where they said it's all mutations, it's all genetics.
Meaning there's nothing you can do about it.
Right, and what they mean by mutations, by the way, is we all have this DNA material, but mistakes start to occur, and when mistakes start to occur, that's where cancer comes from, mistakes in genetics. But this study out of Stony Brook is saying, well, but those mistakes are occurring because of lousy things in your environment. Too much alcohol you're drinking, too many cigarettes you're smoking, air pollution, like in China, we've been talking about that huge air pollution. Or as you showed at the beginning, those hot dogs, which I love, or pastrami sandwiches, they're giving you nitrates that end up causing the mutations in your gut. So things like prostate cancer, breast cancer, colon cancer, skin cancer comes from sunlight. I'm buying this. It's the things we do to ourselves that make those mutations more likely to happen.
And you are the doctor, not me, but what I read is that all cancers start with inflammation. So anything that causes inflammation in your system, anything you're allergic to, anything your system rejects, starts
It's a form of inflammation in the body. You are so right. Now, we have to be inclined to get it. That's where genetics come in. So if your parents have a problem, you may get the problem, but it's that inflammation that causes those changes that leads to the cancer.
So speaking of changes, Scotty, we spoke about there being salt warnings. You know, in New York City, you couldn't buy big sodas for a while. Are you worried about the food police?
I'm worried about more than just the food police, because Uncle Sam has become Dr. Sam as we're leading towards a national single-payer health care system. Make no mistake that this is not only Uncle Sam's not about keeping you here on this earth for your own good. It's more about keeping the greenbacks in his own coat pocket. Considering back in 2012, $87 billion was spent on cancer treatments alone. Now, guess who's fitting the bill? And 11 or more cancer treatments cost $100,000. That's money that Uncle Sam would rather use to buy his shoes than your coffee.
All right. That's well said, Scotty. What are you?
One last thing. I'm worried, but by the way, to her point, that suddenly the nanny state's going to come in and say, can't have that hot dog because, you know, we think it does cause cancer. Worried that the nanny state will use this study to zoom in.
Although I read somewhere that Americans are at risk as a nation of having something like a 20% rate of diabetes, which does beg the question, who pays for all this care, especially in a system where maybe not everybody can afford it.
The taxpayer and Obamacare gives it tax
to
pay.
All right, Scott, I have to give you the last word on that.
Demonize everything fun. It's about taking away your sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
All right, Scotty, we can't say it better. Scotty Nell Hughes, thanks for the time. Dr. Mark Siegel, great to have you here. Great to have you. Well,